Good morning. We have started function. And what is function? Just we have studied. Now today we are going to start types of function. Suppose if this topic will be done in class 12, then types of functions are different. Here we need to learn under function how many types are there, means what are the different kinds of functions we need to understand. First, I will start with polynomial function. What is a polynomial function? You know what a polynomial in class 6, 7, 8 or maybe 9 and 10, wherever you have studied, there is a polynomial function. What is polynomial function? A0 x to the power n, A1 x to the power n minus 1, A2 x to the power n minus 1, similarly an. The function is independent variable is x. A0, A1, A2, An are real values, any real value. It can be anything. Decimal, fraction, whichever value. Then what's about the power of x? The power of x has to be, the exponent of x has to be a natural number or a real number. That means this value, what I'm writing, x to the power, that exponent value cannot be negative. Fraction, irrational. These three I cannot have. So these are the examples of polynomial functions. Linear, quadratic, degree 3, degree 4, any degree, constant function, x to the power 0. Because I put whole number, it can be whole number. So these are polynomial functions. So when it is a polynomial function, what I can take instead of x here? What inputs I can give? I can give any input here. There is no restriction. Because for any value the function exists. So the domain is R. There are so many functions are written, so exactly I don't know the range. But if I substitute x0, output is 4. If I replace 0.1, the output will be different. If I give negative value, maybe it is different. So range equals to R. Now suddenly you will ask sir, what is this domain in range? Already I have given you what is domain, the set of real values for which a function is defined. What I can give as the input such that the function is LI, the function is defined. Range, the output. After giving the inputs, what is the outcome of the function? Output of the function, that is known as the range. So we have studied polynomial function. Now, after polynomial function, the first function is, another function is constant function. Fx is equals to k. What is k? You can see that this is independent of x. For example, we are trying very hard for the examination, but our marks is 40% or 50%. It is fixed. I am not getting sir good marks, though I am studying regularly. You are taking a lot of medicines, but your temperature is not increasing. The fever, 102 or 103, always the fever is constant. Your body weight is not increasing. Though you are taking 3 times meal or 10 times meal, okay, you are not taking anything. That kind of function is known as your body weight is constant. It's not changing. Sir, I am doing a lot of exercise, but still then I am not gaining my weight or neither I am losing my weight. These are the questions maybe. Sir, I am studying whole day through night, but I am not getting good marks. My marks are fixed. I am always lying between these. That means you are a constant function. So, in that case, it is independent of the input. Whatever you do, it is not going to hamper the output. So, fx equals to k. Domain, you are trying a lot. Everything you are trying. So, domain is R. But what's about the range? The range is k. That means, example, fx is equals to sin square x plus cos square x. Whatever you do, the function is not going to change. How the function looks like if r tends to 1? R tends to 1. That means inputs, plenty of inputs are giving. Theta 0 degree, 10 degree, 15 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree, but the output is always 1 for this function. So this kind of function is known as constant function. How the graph will look like? X-axis. Y-axis. 1 hour you are studying, you are getting k marks. 2 hours you are studying, you are getting k marks. 3 hours also studying, you are getting k marks. minus of studying getting k mass, so this is the line. That is equal to k. This is the constant function. Alright? Then comes your identity function. Next one is identity function. Fx is equal to x. The function whose output is same as the input. That is known as identity function. Fx is equal to x. This is a part of polynomial function. The previous one, constant function, is also part of polynomial function. Whatever is the input, same is the output. You can give one, you will get one. Give two, get two. So domain is R. I can give any input, there is no restriction. Because this is a polynomial function. Range also R. Fx other name is y, so I can consider this and y is equal to x. How the graph will look like? 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1 here, 2, 2 here, 0, 0, 3, 3. This graph is it passes from origin y is equal to x means 45 degrees. This is the graph of the identity function and this is the graph of y is equal to minus. Later on we need it. Then comes your reciprocal function. Reciprocal, from the name you can find out the reciprocal means reverse. Fx equals to 1 by x. If your function is in the numerator, then numerator can be 0. But if it comes to denominator, the variable terms comes to denominator, suddenly you find out there is a condition x is not equal to 0. From your childhood, you might have seen in the rational function. P by Q, Q is not equal to 0. The same condition is here. X is not equal to 0. That means this is the domain. I can take all the values other than 0. Because if I replace it 0 here, gives me undefined value. That means the function must not give me undefined value in the first day I told you. So this is domain is equal to R minus 0. Now let us find out the range. How to find out the range? Range means the outcome of the function. Y is equal to 1 by x. Turn in the form of this 1 by y. Y is not equal to 0. Same condition, suppose if someone asks you, tell me the condition for this 1 by 1. It tells us y should not be equal to 0. That is the range. All the values I will get other than 0. Alright? Next. Graph. This is 1, 1, 2, 3. If I replace 1, I am getting 1. But if I am replacing 2, I am getting 1 by 2. If I am replacing 2, I am getting 1 by 2. If I am replacing 3, it is 1 by 3. If 1 by 2 is replaced, I am getting 2. So the graph you can see going like this. Here also. This is a graph of y is equal to 1 by x. Fx is equal to 1 by x plus 4. find the domain in there. Find the dominant range. So what I do here? Delta of x is not equal to minus 4. So domain is equal to r minus minus 4. I can consider all the values. Denominator should not be equal to 0. Range I got, domain I got. How to find out the range? Consider the whole function equals to y. X plus 4 is equals to 1 by y, x is equals to 1 by y minus 4, x is equals to 1 minus 4 y by y. Suppose if someone gives you this question and tells, asks you, what is the domain of this function? Forget about the variable y, just tell you what is the domain of this function. You will tell, sir, numerator can be 0 but denominator cannot be 0. So y is not equal to 0, y cannot be 0. That means the domain for this function is the range of the original function. So y cannot be equal to 0. So range becomes to r minus 0. Alright, another question. Fx to x minus 1 by x plus 3. Domain x plus 3 is not equal to 0. R minus minus 3. Domain. We got the domain. Let's find out the range. Plus multiply. What I did, I got the value of x here. Now similarly you think, what should be the denominator value here? Y cannot be equal to 1. So range equals to r minus 1. I can consider all the values of the universe other than 1. So range equals to r minus 1. Then comes your square root function. The next function is your square root function. Fx is equals to under root of x. What you know the condition about under root of x? You know that x should be greater than or equal to 0 because I cannot consider a negative number here. I cannot consider negative values here. So that is the domain. So domain is number line, if I consider 0 to infinity close. So domain is closed interval 0 to infinity. Range generally if I will ask you what is the square root of 16, it will be telling plus minus 4. No, in class 11 and 12, I have to think about the function because the condition for function already I have given you. What is that? The condition for one input, the outputs cannot be different. What kind of function it is? Fx equal to square root of x. That means if I give 16, if I write down plus minus 4, the answer is plus minus 4. That means here is 16, here I am writing 4 and minus 4 both. It cannot be a function. So either I have to consider the plus values or I have to consider the minus value. Depends upon my input. As we are dealing with the positive real values here, so my answer is range is 0 to infinity. Then you may ask me, sir, where I will consider both plus and minus? That is, we are going to consider the coordinate system. Coordinate system, when all the quadrants are available to me, that case I will consider plus minus 4, plus minus 3, whatever it is. Then we will come back to the curve, the graph. Y is equal to root x. If I square it, y square is equal to x. This is a parabolic function. Y square is equal to x is a parabolic function. This is the graph of y square equals to 4x. Now suppose if I remove y square is equal to 4x, the graph will look like y square is equal to x, same graph, but this is y square. But I told, if I take 16, I will get plus 4 and minus 4. I have to delete this in the linear graph. So for this graph, it is only the upper part. This part is not existing. So this is the graph of y is equal to root x, the parabolic graph. Okay, that's the square root function. So what you have studied from here, the domain is always positive values, range positive numbers. Yeah. Next.
Then next downwards, difficult questions of square root, then we'll go to other functions.